I am assuming that you have opened the Blender, and you will see an in splash screen like this, and you can start an 2D animation file or a general file, and click here, and you will see this is the panel. Today you are going to discuss how we can using the move and rotate and scale. Basically, I am using Emulate 3D. A 3-button mouse. So if you don't have the scroll and you have Apple mouse, you don't have the scroll, you can emulate 3-button mouse. If you are using a graphic tablet, you can emulate the 3-button mouse. If you have a tablet, a laptop, you can emulate the numpad. Let's save, and after that you have the move your object or rotate. You can click here and move in the x-axis. So what is the x-axis? X-axis, which is red one, green axis, which is the y-axis. Should activate that. So the green axis, which is the y-axis, the blue axis, which is the z-axis. If you don't know these coordinates, it's any scene or any 3D world have these axes, because in the space we have only these 3 axes, one for the width, one for the length, one for the height, and the fourth dimension, which is the time, of course. So now you can move your object in the scene. You can click in the left, click by left click, and using only one axis, you can move in one axis, or you can move in the y or in x or in z axis. Using Alt R and Alt J, you will make it to be moved to be the center. How we can move this object by precision? You want to move it in the x-axis by using only 1 meter. So I will move by grab or G. If you hover over of here, you will see that G or shift spacebar will move. I am using the G, R and S because this is the standard to move and rotate. If you are using an old version, you can go for the preference. If you are using Blender before and you are using an old version, which is 2.7, you can use the shortcuts for 2.7, and the shortcuts in Blender 2.9 has been changed and is different than 2.7. and if you are using Max or Maya, you can change to be industry compatible, so you can make it compatible and using the shortcuts for Maya or Max to be the same in Blender. So how we can move it by precision, maybe 2 meters in the axis? I will click GX2. How we can move in the y-axis to be 3 meters, so GY3. How we can move in the z-axis only 50 centimeters or 0.5 meter, so GZ 0.5. It's only not in the positive axis, so we can move in the wrong axis, which is the negative axis. So GX minus 5, GY minus 4, GY minus 4, and GZ minus 2, and Alt G to be in the center again. The rotate is the same, so we can rotate in the Y axis, we can rotate in the X axis, we can rotate in the Z axis, and we can again, we can rotate in the x-axis by 45 degrees, or rotate in the z-axis 90 degrees, or rotate in the y minus 45. Again, we can scale by using S. The shortcut for scaling is S. We can scale in the x-axis, we can scale in the y-axis, we can scale in the z-axis. All of these are using the S shortcut. And if you want to be resized, so you can scale in the x-axis 0.5, or scale in the y-axis 2, or scale in z 4 or 5, and it will be scaled in the all the dimensions. Again, Alt S will be go to the basic scale. So what about the selection? Select here is by using left click, and you can delete your object by using X and delete, or you can using delete from the keyboard, it will be deleted from the first time. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next video.